Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. As you can see, we're here on Twitter on the Op Global Blackout Search. We'll bring this up to date. I want to give everybody a warning and a little bit of, assumptions on my part now. The Op Global Blackout does not make sense to me. You people have to keep in mind that anonymous can be anyone, anything, anywhere, anytime, if a group of like-minded individuals decides. Well, what if those like-minded individuals were members of the government? Now, I want you to make note that although it's portrayed that the anonymous is taking part in Op Global Blackout, notice that these profiles, most of which, almost all of which, are not anonymous members. They're not anonymous. They don't have an anonymous symbol, photo, or otherwise. Okay, we got to keep in mind the sock puppet program that the government leads, who has created tens of thousands of online personas to look like real people to glean. Now they're using those gleaning sock puppet accounts to spread this Op Global Blackout bullshit. You've also got to keep in mind that the anonymous that fight for internet freedoms have not been known to take out means of communication. I point that out because, as this Twitterer had put out, I knew when I saw the word fake there was something that I had to see. So I use the IM translator that I have here. Is fake. Anonymous does not attack means of communication. This Twitterer is on the ball and absolutely right. They do not. They use Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. Especially now that the 4chan network has been infiltrated, many of them just exist on the social network. So it doesn't make sense that they would cut their own throats by shutting it down. A big heads up, okay, because just as the Occupy movement seemed like such a great thing, and then when we find out, we dig into it, we find out that George Soros's money was backing a large faction of that. Op Global Blackout? Well, I for one don't expect it.